House Republicans are, as always, falling over themselves, trying to come up with ways to suck up to Donald Trump. And this one is truly comical. Seven different Republicans have introduced a bill to literally rename the airport of Washington. This is Dulles Airport. They want it to be the Donald J. Trump International Airport. Now, this seems like an April Fool's thing, and it did come out on April Fool's. But you can take a look at this. It's an actual bill. It's in the system at congress.gov to rename it to the Donald J. Trump International Airport. Now, doing something as silly as that, I think would require good reasons. So the representative says, in my lifetime, our nation has never been greater than under the leadership of President Donald J. Trump. As millions of domestic and international travelers fly through the airport, there is no better symbol of freedom, prosperity and strength than hearing welcome to Trump International Airport as they land on American soil. Saying that, Trump, it makes it sound like one of his stupid steaks or his ties. It's like a cheap product. Do you get that, GOP? The Trump name is not affiliated with luxury or opulence anymore. It's a con job and we can see through it. But the idea that America has never been stronger than under Trump, you know, except for that last bit, you know, where hundreds of thousands of people were dropping dead left and right and the economy absolutely cratered because our government didn't take the pandemic remotely seriously and set us up for a difficult but eventual recovery once that guy was no longer occupying the White House. But forget all of that stuff.
Before we continue with the story, we depend on members to keep on going. Don't wait, click join now on YouTube.
So this is what they want to do. They want to rename DC's airport. There's some specific irony to that, which we'll get into. But Sabrina, what do you think about that?
You know, it's so interesting how, you know, Trump is still alive while they're trying to supposedly, you know, name this airport after him. And yet just a few years ago, when they wanted to start naming like various infrastructure and stuff after Obama, there was so much resistance. Like, yep, he's still alive. That's a disgraceful thing to do. And now all of a sudden, when the names are flipped and it's Trump, they're all for it. Totally. It's just, it's so backwards. I don't think it's going to mean much whether they end up changing it or not. But yeah, it's just what a funny issue to die on.
You are more relaxed about this than me. It doesn't mean much, but it cannot happen, obviously. That is absurd. Not only because you, as you point out, generally we wait until people pass on. Not always. There have been, you know, like Navy ships that have been named after sitting presidents. It's a thing that sometimes happens. But in particular, of all, if you want to name Anchorage's airport or whatever, nothing against Alaska, or like, I don't know, some rural airport in Louisiana, or if, you know, Miami wants to do it, they love him in Florida or whatever, feel free. But DC's airport in particular,
yeah,
for a couple of reasons, I have a problem with that. So first of all, if we jump ahead to graphic five, in DC, he got 5.4% of the vote. That sounds like something like that Saddam Hussein would have set up for something like, they don't like him at all there and they gotta see it. Also, I think he conducted a coup in Washington DC, if I remember correctly. It like, I have a tickle in the back of my mind. I feel like he tried to overturn the results of the election and sent a mob at the Capitol and they beat dozens of cops. Some of them eventually died. They broke down the building, they pooped all over the place. Like, I feel like that's what he did in that city. So of all of the places to memorialize him, I feel like DC should be one of the last, honestly. But anyway, Sabrina, any other thoughts? Who would you can name it after someone new. It's not gonna be Dulles anymore, it's gonna be some other airport. What do you think?
Oh God. If it's not, okay, if it doesn't end up being, you know, Donald Trump, I think you were onto something with Saddam. I think they could, they have the same likeliness.
I don't know if that's going to be super popular either, but I would say if it had to be renamed, look, I was critical of Barack Obama and I'm not saying he should get it, but you know, nothing horrendous happened while he was president. They did their healthcare bill and I don't know, there was some good stuff, I guess. But I would say, can we go like, does it have to be a politician? Could it be like the Dolly Parton International Airport or something? Is that impossible? Could Betty White get some recognition? Because if you're talking about like people landing and then like being happy to see the name, Trump isn't the name that puts smiles on people's faces. Dolly Parton and Betty White put smiles on people's faces. I say recognize them.
No, you should give Nashville to Dolly if she's going to have any airport. Nashville, hands down. But Betty White, though, I think Betty White.
Not saying anything, just saying.
For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.